This video is about Boolean circuits. Boolean circuits are the building blocks of digital electronics, and are one of the many technological advances allowing you to watch this video on your favorite device. Much of their success and reliability hinges on their simplicity, in contrast to classical analog electronics. Boolean circuits are built of so-called logic gates. Each gate has a number of binary inputs and a single binary output. For instance, this OR gate has two inputs, X and Y, and produces a single output, which is 1 if and only if at least one of its inputs is 1. Similarly, the AND gate gives a 1 output if and only if both of its inputs are 1. Note that there are also versions of these two gates with more than two inputs. Finally, the NOT gate flips its input. That is, if it was 1 it becomes 0, and vice versa. Logic gates can be composed to yield larger circuits, with more intriguing properties. To challenge yourself, pause the video right now to see if you can figure out what is the output of this circuit. To understand this circuit, we label each wire with its value. The top OR gate computes its output, and feeds this value as input to the rightmost AND. The bottom gate computes the conjunction of the two inputs. This value is then negated by the NOT gate. Finally, the rightmost gate ANDs together the two values. The resulting expression is the output of the circuit. By inspecting it, we observe that this evaluates to 1, precisely when X and Y differ. This is also called a parity circuit, or the exclusive OR of X and Y. Other than their practical applicability, circuits are also interesting to study theoretically, many believing that they are the tool to answering the P versus NP question. Similar to SAT, we can define the circuit SAT problem. Here, given a circuit, we want to know whether there is a collection of inputs for which the circuit evaluates to 1. As it turns out, circuit SAT is also NP complete. To see this, first note that the problem is in NP, because any collection of inputs for which the circuit evaluates to 1 can act as a certificate. Moreover, a very simple reduction from SAT shows that it is also NP hard. In particular, any Boolean formula can be transformed into a Boolean circuit by replacing the Boolean operators with the corresponding logic gates. Let's now ask a more practical question, important for efficient digital circuit design. Given some Boolean function, such as the one implemented by this complicated circuit, and some number k, find a circuit using at most k logical gates, implementing this functionality. This is known as Mcsp, or the minimum size circuit problem. The problem is in NP, if the logical function is given as a truth table, since any circuit of size at most k can be efficiently checked for implementing the truth table. Note that this would not be immediately true if the function had been given as a circuit, but this is not the case in the standard formulation of the problem. The problem seems very difficult. In fact, it is so difficult that even with the whole truth table given as input, which has size exponential in n, no polynomial algorithm in the size of the truth table is known to solve it. So, is it NP complete? The answer, sadly, is that we do not know. We know that it is NP complete if the circuit is allowed to have multiple outputs, but for the single output case, it is one of the most studied questions in circuit complexity. We have seen that the number of gates in a circuit is an important parameter in reducing manufacturing costs. However, there is a second parameter used to define the computational efficiency of a circuit. To define it, let's do so with a riddle. Assume that we want to implement a 4-input AND, but all we have at our disposal are classical 2-input AND gates. Pause the video right now to see if you can figure out how such a circuit can be implemented. The answer is that there are two ways of doing so. One of them is more efficient than the other. Pause the video again to see if you can figure out which one and why. The top circuit is a fully sequential circuit, having a depth of 3 gates. However, the bottom circuit is more parallel, computing 2 conjunctions at the same time, and then using a 3rd gate on the results. Thus, it has a depth of only 2 gates, hence being more efficient. In general, this binary tree-shaped construction can be used to implement an input conjunction with a circuit of logarithmic depth. The depth of the circuit is a measure of circuit parallelizability. Some problems are inherently more parallel than others. To quantify this effect, researchers have introduced circuit complexity classes. For instance, computing the conjunction of n binary inputs is in NC sub 1, meaning that for any number of inputs, there is a circuit with polynomial Lemmeni gates and logarithmic depth that computes conjunction. In contrast, computing this conjunction is not in NC sub 0, for which the depth has to be constant, rather than logarithmic. Furthermore, there also exist NC sub 2, and so on, four circuits where the depth is allowed to grow as fast as the logarithm squared, or higher powers of the logarithm. Finally, these classes are defined for circuits where the number of inputs to each gate has to be at most 2, but they also have analogs denoted with AC, where gates with many inputs are allowed. For instance, our n-input conjunction is in AC sub 0, because a single multi-input n-gate solves the problem in depth 1. Thanks for watching this video.